Hey there, good morning, welcome to Prog Monster. My name is Murph, I am a host of this show, a show that's dedicated to progressive rock, hard rock, heavy metal, and on the occasion, other music other than rock. So, today's our normal Sunday afternoon, this week on the channel, that's what the name of the show is actually called, just this week. Any of you who've been following it will notice that I always put like the number, whatever episode number this is. So this will be number 8, but I'm also going to include the dates, like from when to when, so that people aren't as confused about what they're watching. Just makes it easier for you to find what you want to find. So for this episode 8 will start on August the 28th today. And it will finish on September the 3rd, next Saturday. That's generally how I'm going to run it, Sunday to Saturday, every week. So we have a fair number of episodes coming out this week, 9 in total. The first one, of course, will be this one. And this one we're just basically talking about, for you people who haven't watched this episode, just talking about what's going to happen on the channel this week. So the first show to come on the channel this week will be on Monday night, our Monday night look back at a classic rock album. This week, I originally was going to do one album and I switched it because I removed an album from my playlist and decided I wanted to do that one as the album of the classic album look back of the week. And the album I've chosen is this one. Many of you will know that this is Nektar's Recycled album. It's a really colorful album. It's the one thing about Nektar I like quite a bit. Their albums are quite colorful. And the artwork is really good. It's another shot of it. Sometimes a bit too distorted and hard to look at, but it gives the impression, the same as their Tab of the Ocean album, which was one I did earlier, gives a kind of a real impression of a kind of a space kind of thing, and I like that about them. I like their music quite a bit. So that'll be the album we're doing this week on Monday night. Look back at a classic rock album. Okay, so the next show up will occur on Wednesday in the afternoon. And that will be my hauls. That's all the stuff that I purchased for the week of... For the month of August. They've got 17 in total, I believe. But I always miss one or two because they're either in the playlist, they're either out in the front room where I'm listening to the music, or I've moved them over somewhere because I was looking at them and I forget to include them. So that happens fairly regularly. I just throw them in, so they just end up being in September's haul, even though they were purchased in August. There's not usually more than one or two anyways. Okay, so there's 17 of them this month, as far as I know. Not very much progressive rock, which surprised me. I thought I had purchased more, but there wasn't a lot. I will be concentrating now until Christmas on buying progressive stuff. I've seen quite a bit of it out there that I want, so it's just a matter of getting the funds and the time to go and get it. And then, of course, progressive always takes longer to get into and listen to because it's usually more complex and not as penetrable as other music. Okay, so that will be the Wednesday afternoon. On Wednesday evening, of course, we'll have our favorites. Wednesday night favorites. So I originally was going to do a top 10 of this category, but after I started thinking about it and thinking about all the albums I wanted to include, I thought, oh, wow, there's a lot. So I'm going to make it a top 25, and it's going to follow this theme I did last week, which was my 10 top favorite bands I've recently discovered in the past year since the beginning of the this channel. And now I'm going to do a top 25 albums that I recently discovered over the past year since I started the channel. I didn't think there would be more than 10, but there's a lot more. I've listened to a lot of albums. I didn't realize that I wanted to include it in this show. And that'll be, some albums were only had just were coming to an end right around the beginning of this channel, and others were like fully in during the whole time, and some are in the channel now or on my playlist now. So there's a lot, and a lot of really good stuff too. Like, you know, my world has gotten bigger. You know, more than a year ago, it was Rush, and we'll throw something else in there just to break up the monotony. But I've discovered there's more in rock music than just Rush. Of course, I've always known that, but I have this real affinity for listening to Rush. And the funniest part is the last 6 months, I don't think I've listened to much Rush because it's just so much other stuff to listen to right now. So anyways, we'll be doing a top 25 of recently discovered albums. And that is recently discovered for me because some of these albums are ancient, like older. Some of them are almost as old as me, but I only have either heard one song off of them or had very little impact or didn't know about them. So I never owned any of these albums, and I've only started listening to any of them in the last year or so. So that will be my criteria, and it'll be my top 10 based on my own personal feelings about the album. And I'll talk a bit about each of the album. I don't want to go into great depth about them because I'll probably do them, a lot of them, in the look back at classic rock album on Monday eventually. So I will talk about them though to some degree. So that will be my top 25 for the Wednesday night favorites. Okay, moving right along. Since Wednesday is the final day of this month, we will be starting our series, which will go for the month of September. What was I going to title this? I completely lost. Oh yeah, it's right here. I forgot. My Strange Fascinations is going to be the title of this series, and it's basically about artists or rock bands or rock artists that have had some kind of impact on my life in particular. So you learn a little bit more about myself. Not always good at revealing that kind of stuff, but this will give me a chance to do that in a kind of fun setting. And also you'll get to see why some bands mean more to me than others when, you know, there's always going to be people out there that think, well, Pink Floyd is here, Led Zeppelin is here, the Beatles are here, and there is no way that anybody else could ever crack that. Well, I'm sorry to tell you, we all look at music differently. And this is not my saying as much as I've heard him say it. I've heard Winch say it as well. It's just how music hits us in our life at the time it hits us. That's just the way it is, you know. So we'll be doing a series on this, which will be 30 episodes, one for each day of the month. My Strange Fascinations. I decided originally wasn't going to do them in any particular order, but I thought, you know what, I don't want it to be anticlimactic. So what we'll do is I will talk about the ones who had the most impact on me at the end of the month. So it'll go from the least impactful to the most impactful. Within a relativity, I mean, you know, I may put one guy on there who's, I might put him like third or fourth, and he might actually be eighth or ninth. You know, I'm not going to be like so rigid that it, you know, I'm going to spend forever figuring it out. I've already actually done it. I already know the order in which they're going to go. And so we'll be doing three for this week, one on Thursday, one on Friday, and one on Saturday. And the artists that I'm going to be talking about, the first episode will feature Beatle legend John Lennon. This guy with the beard, or without the beard in this case. Some nice shots of him here. The reason I chose a Beatle album to show him was because I wasn't really much into his solo career. I did listen to Double Fantasy and Imagine and a couple of other things by him, but pretty much it was his Beatles influence on me. And to me, he's the most impactful of the Beatles. So we're going to be doing John Lennon. Actually, I may have put one of the other ones in there too. And at a glance, I don't really see any of them at a glance. But so I may have chosen John Lennon. It'll be a little bit of a talk about him and the Beatles as well, because that's the impact. Okay, so the number two guy, which will come on the second day, will be Ian Thomas, Canadian singer, brother of Dave Thomas from Second City TV. There's a couple songs that he put out that I still like a lot, and I still sing them all the time. And people go, "What the hell is that?" So we'll be doing him. And then the third person will be another Canadian from a band that I liked quite a bit in their time, and I like his solo stuff, and I've actually met him, and he's had a little bit of personal impact on my life, and that's Kim Mitchell. So those would be the first three. Now, I'm not going to do this every week, list all of the people I'm going to do, because then it kind of defeats the purpose. But for the first episodes, I wanted to kind of establish it. So there you have it with my strange fascinations. Okay, so moving along, we come to Friday, the Friday Night Live experience, and we are going to be doing this album. And for those of you who watched last week's live, it was the shorts. This is the longs, volume two, the longs, you know, featuring quite a bit of stuff, more stuff here that I like than probably was on the first one. So anyways, we'll be doing that for the Friday Night Live experience, Genesis Live, The Way We Walk, The Longs, Volume 2. Okay, and then Saturday morning, for those of you who like stuff other than rock like myself, we're going to feature an artist that, you know, kind of touches in the rock genre a bit. However, this person is among my favorite vocalists of all time, or singers if you prefer. The music is got some kind of island sounds to it, of course, and some calypso sounds to it, and maybe even some reggae sounds to it. And of course, we're talking about this diva here, Rihanna. Now, the thing about Rihanna is that I'm not suggesting that she's better than Etta James or Aretha Franklin or Adele or any of those people that, you know, you may have come to associate with this kind of music, or that kind of, even Beyonce, you know. But I love her voice, and she has a unique position with me in that I never discovered her through my daughter, like Miley Cyrus, Selena Gomez, Adele, some of this other stuff that my daughter liked. I got into fun because I was listening to it with her, and she does like Rihanna too, but Rihanna was a discovery of my own. I got an album somewhere and was listening to it, and it was actually this one, and I just love this album. I think it's fantastic, and I really love her voice. She just has one of those voices that resonate with me in all kinds of ways. So I want to give some attention to her. I have like four or five of her albums. The first three are like beautiful albums. I love them all. Then it kind of gets a little strange, as she does herself. Okay, so then we get to, that's the Saturday morning music other than rock, which will come out on Saturday morning. So that's basically the stuff I'm going to be doing this week. There's 9 videos in total. So I hope that you guys can, you know, use this show to maybe decide which ones you're going to watch and when you're going to watch them, and which ones interest you and which ones maybe don't. That's my whole job, is to try and make this fun and interesting and promote this music that I love so much, and get people talking about stuff and thinking about stuff. You know, maybe you never thought about Rihanna before, or maybe you had no knowledge of Ian Thomas, or maybe you don't like Nectar, but you've never heard of Nectar and you want to listen to them, and so I'm going to talk a little bit about those things, you know. So anyways, I hope that you will enjoy this episode, and if you do, please like and subscribe, as it helps me and I appreciate it a lot. And I hope you have a great Sunday afternoon, and we will see you soon on the next episode. Bye.